नमस्कार, आई एम रामदास परसुले, अ क्लासिकल म्यूजिशियन, तबला प्लेयर एंड अ गुरु फ्रॉम पुणे. आई वुड लाइक टू थैंक डॉक्टर नागराज, विवेक कन्नडी एंड देयर टीम फ्रॉम आईसर पुणे फॉर इनवाइटिंग मी फॉर दिस प्रोजेक्ट और इनिशिएटिव, यू कैन से, of 10 questions for 10 Punekars regarding this COVID-19 pandemic. I will try my best to express my views in English, but my sincere apologies for my English is not so good, but I will try my best. So thank you once again, and here are my answers to all your questions. Thank you. And the most challenging part is, of course, no one getting opportunity or invitation for a public performance. No public concerts happening anywhere in the world. So that is the most challenging part. All musicians stuck in their homes. All their students are gone back to their respective hometowns. So because of no concerts happening, there is no income. So many musicians are also facing the financial crisis. Seniors can withstand or sustain through this bad situation, but juniors, young upcoming musicians, are really facing this bad timing, going through this bad timing and facing a lot of financial problems. I think that is the most challenging part. Thank you. That's true. Pune is one of the major cultural hubs of India, and I'm very much proud of it. All musicians in Pune are proud of it. So coping with this COVID-19 situation, because of this technology, now one can teach online for a student anywhere, who is anywhere in world. So there are my students in Europe, in North America, in Australia, in UAE. So many musicians might be having students from all over the world. So they are now started teaching online. Also, slowly online commercial concerts, paid concerts are also happening. The initial days were really difficult, but now slowly, due to paid online concerts and online workshops, the situation is improving a little bit. And I hope the situation will be better soon. Thank you. Yes, there are definitely a few organizations and individuals who are supporting the musicians who are in problematic situation. The individuals I know are Shri Dhananjay Gokhale of Mitra Foundation. He has supported more than 75 or maybe more than that musicians in last 3-4 months. Also, there are individuals like Shri Satish Desai ji, Dr. Satish Desai, Shekhar Kendale, and even my student Vaibhav Garge. So these people have supported the musicians who are in financial crisis, and there are many organizations who have started doing online paid concerts. So definitely there are efforts being taken to help the musicians. Thank you. As I told you in my reply to the previous question, yes, many organizations and organizers have started arranging online paid concerts, which is very helpful for all the musicians who are participating in their concerts. So, and because these organizers are from Pune, and because of lockdown situation, they can invite only musicians from Pune. So many Pune musicians are performing in these online concerts. They are also getting benefited financially, as well as their music goes worldwide. They get audience from all over the world. So that is win-win situation. I don't know about these organizers or organization helping financially to the needy musicians, but I'm sure they must be doing that too. Of course, these digital platforms have helped the music world a lot. If this pandemic had come earlier, maybe 15-20 years back, then the music world would have been in more trouble, in deeper trouble. But thanks to the technology of today and due to these digital platforms, they can perform online, they can get audience from all over the world, they can earn money by performing online or by teaching online or by conducting workshops online. So this has really definitely have helped the musicians, and mostly for the younger generation, because they need that opportunity to perform in front of the audience. If not physically in front of audience, but at least through online concerts. So these digital platforms have helped a lot. Yeah, I have performed quite a few online concerts. Sometimes live online concerts, sometimes recorded online concerts. I have been interviewed quite a few times for a live interview session. Also, I had participated in many webinars on different topics. So yeah, and the overall experience was quite good. I was very happy. Happy for the webinars, happy for the interviews, and happy to perform online. Though it is not equal to the live public concerts, but still, we do many recordings otherwise also in the studios of All India Radio or in private studios for some private projects. So it is like it is same, I think. Performing online is the same. Good question. I think The answer is yes, because when you perform online, you get audience from all over the world. So there are more chances of getting more audience for a concert online when you perform online as compared to when you have any public concert. There are more chances. And these online concerts, people watch them from their home. So automatically, maybe all the family member might be watching these online concerts. So maybe you have more younger audience when you perform online. I think so. According to me, classical music, or we can say any kind of music, spreads the positivity. So to follow the music by listening to it, or by practicing to it, or by performing, you get the positivity. Either you get the positivity, or you spread the positivity, or you do the both things. So this positivity we need a lot during such pandemic situations. And I think if we promote more music online, if we promote music to more people, so it will be easier to get over this pandemic situation. Music is very important. It's very positive. Frankly speaking, my daily routine before pandemic and during pandemic has not changed a lot. When I was at home, what was my daily routine earlier is the same routine now also. So besides my own riyaz, sadhana, or listening to other musicians online on YouTube or whatever, my favorite thing for relaxation is to watch new channels like Republic TV or Times Now, to watch debates on these channels, and also to watch sports channels. Mostly I watch cricket and tennis and soccer, football, and also sometimes movies. So that is my favorite thing for relaxation. I stay in Pune. I stay in old Pune city, you can say, in Sadashivpet, which is very crowded. We are in the heart of the city, and all the marketplace is around us. Lakshmi Road, Tulsi Bagh, Mandai, everything is around us. We are in the middle of those places. So it is always crowded. So we want to take all the precautions, so to keep away the corona and infection, and so we don't invite anybody to, unfortunately we are not inviting anybody to our home, and we are not going out of our home. This is very unfortunate, but if you want to talk to any of very close friends or relatives, we call them on a video call and we talk to them. So that is the unfortunate, but what we are following. Good question. Nobody knows when the normalcy will be back. We hope that it will be back soon, but my prediction is this year is gone, and not just this year. Our peak music season, which is from Diwali to Holi, that is, which goes up to March, is gone. And unless we get the vaccination and all people are vaccinated, there are less chances of public concerts happening. So I think we will have to wait for them till next music season. So next, it is 2021 Diwali. We have to wait till then. But I really pray God and hope that the normalcy comes very soon and everything becomes normal and we can perform in public concerts and festivals. Thank you so much.